Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about something very simple, and that's maintenance for your key tumblers on your vehicle. As cars get older, I see a lot of time that the tumblers get worn out. Now, typically a tumbler doesn't turn because the key's so worn out that it doesn't push everything out of the way in order for it to turn, because you see all these little ridges and highs and lows. This is what allows the key to turn afterwards, unlocking it. Typically what you see is the key is worn out, but there are times where you have a key tumbler that just gets sticky. This one's fine, but they do get sticky over time, and that's because no one ever does any maintenance on them. I have three types of products here that you would typically see or use when you're doing your maintenance. Now, typically what everyone uses is WD-40, and WD-40 is a great lubricant. It's supposed to be a water displacement material. That's what the WD stands for, but people have found so many uses for it. And I actually have tried different types of films and lubricants to do different things, like lubricate hinges and also go into the strikers of the doors. I actually prefer WD-40. WD-40 you have to apply more often, but what's nice about WD-40 is it doesn't gum up over time compared to other brands or other types of films. Like if you use that really thick stuff like fluid film, it tends to gum up, so I stopped using that stuff. However, I would only use this in certain parts of the door and on the key tumbler. I would not use this on the inside where the ignition key goes in to start the vehicle. Now back in the day, when cars didn't have chip keys, people will typically use graphite in the key tumbler. This is fine. It's like a very thin film and it's meant for long endurance over time, and it helps keys not get so stuck. However, you don't want to spray this stuff in a vehicle that has an electronic immobilizer. That's where something like this comes in. This is called Mul-T-Lock. I actually would talk to the local locksmith and I was asking them, is there anything I can put into the key tumbler that's safe? And this is. So it does say on a mechanical and electromechanical cylinder lubricant. Just a couple sprays inside the key tumbler, do it like twice a year, and this will make sure that that key tumbler lasts for a very long time, because we all know we don't want to ever change that. You probably won't if you bought the car brand new, you'll probably sell the car. But for those of you buying used vehicles, using stuff like this is going to make things last a lot longer, things that we don't think about and things that cost a lot of money to replace. For the key tumbler, it's very simple. Make sure that you use the straw that comes with the bottle. Shake the can and a couple of squirts in. Have a rag ready to get any of the residue off. Now take your key and just work it in there. Now for added maintenance, I like to lubricate the hinges. Now, depending on the vehicle, for daily drivers, you can do this, but if it's like a show car, you might want to have the rag ready and catch any of the residue. Because what I do is I put this on the hinges, but what you can see, if we got a little bit closer, we have dirt building up over time. That's because of the lubricant that we're applying on. Now, brands like that are very thick, or that white lithium grease are going to hold it more. Anything that's not as liquidy is going to have that issue. So that's something you have to keep in mind. On a daily driver like this truck, I don't really care. I even shoot in here where I can't really wax the vehicle just to inhibit any kind of rust. I prefer WD-40 over silicone spray in this application, because on these plastic parts, it does squeak quite a bit. Here's another quick little tip. This is where I do like to use silicone spray. I will spray some onto a rag and you'll put some on the molding. One, this is going to maintain the molding over time. Two, on those cold winter days when there's a little bit of moisture here. Have you guys ever noticed, those of you that experience winters or below zero degrees Celsius, not Fahrenheit, that your doors get stuck? It's because the ice between, well, the moisture between the door and the molding turns into ice and it kind of fuses them together. So by putting a little bit of silicone lube on here, we'll prevent that over time. I do this every season. Okay, here's where the Mul-T-Lock comes into play. This stuff is safe for tumblers. Now this truck, it's a hybrid of having a mobilizer. It is still mainly mechanical, because on these pass lock systems of this generation, it's based on how the keys cut. But I do use this stuff in my 350Z, which does have an immobilizer that's electronic with a chip key. So all you do is just two quick little spurts, get any residue, and get your keys again, and just work it in there. And I would do this probably, you know, I don't think I have to do it that often, maybe twice a year, if that. And that makes sure that the key tumbler doesn't wear out prematurely. These things do last for a very long time, but added maintenance is going to get that much more life out of it, because changing out pieces like this is very expensive.
Well, there you guys have it. Some quick and easy maintenance tips. To check what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram, Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca. Yeah.